Greetings. Today I am going to introduce sunbeams, also called sun rays and also known as God rays. You may be already familiar with them. It is when a ray of light is visible on the screen, which creates a beautiful effect. In this video, you will learn how this can be done in Daz3D. This time we are starting with a blank scene, so let's create the scene. First of all, we need some environment to work with. There are quite a bit of environments available for free. I have particularly liked the Alchemy Chasm one as it fits perfect for this task. So this ledge in the middle with the sun symbol on it looks like a perfect place to put some sun rays on. Before proceeding, I am making this environment unselectable, so it would not glow yellow each time I mouse over it. After selecting the environment, I would usually add a character to the scene, then add some clothes and hair to them. But there is no need to add a character to this scene, as I am just showing sun rays and there is no need in a figure, it would just prolong the rendering. So let's see how the scene looks in the rendered view. Not very good, it is dark and not interesting. Mainly because of the only source of lighting, not very descend HDR image. So I will just disable it. Instead, I will add a spotlight, as it is the best light source for creating God rays. It should be pointing at the spot where we want a God ray at an angle, preferably from above. I point it right on this sun on the floor. Next, it is needed to create a camera, so we can work around it and render from it. Also, don't forget to increase the luminous flux of the spotlight by a lot, as it is too weak by default. We can see the scene rendered now and adjust the camera accordingly. No signs of the sunbeams yet. We need to add a special object first that will help us produce God rays. This object is called a diffuse mesh. It is a mesh that will catch and diffuse the lighting. This will create an effect that we want. Absolutely any object can be used, so I find it a good idea to use a simple cube. It is easy to work with and is very low poly. Now I need to place it on the place where I want my sun rays to be. And scale it, so it would cover not only the exact place but also everything around it. From the camera view, we see that it is where we want it, but right now it just obstructs the scene and we can't see anything. Right now the cube is just a regular object and we will use surfaces settings to make it a diffuse mesh instead. First of all, we change glossy layered weight and glossy reflectivity, because we need this object to be very rough, with no reflections whatsoever. Then you need to change refraction weight. Easy to notice that it makes the object invisible. This is what we need, so set it to 1 to make it fully see-through. Lower here there is a thin walled setting we need to turn off for these setting to appear that we need. But this did mess with the scene, it looks very weird and deformed. This time it is because even though an object is invisible, it still has refractions. So I just change the refraction index to 1.0 and it will fix the problem. Returning to the appeared settings, here you have scattering measurement distance, SSS amount, and SSS direction. I will just start changing them and we will see what happens to the scene. First is scattering distance. There is no cap to the setting, so I can set it to something very high, like 100. Nothing happens though. We need to add other settings for this to work, so increase SSS amount. The result is very obvious. We can see the cube again, but it is very foggy and see-through, looks like a cloud. After adding SSS direction, it is gone again, only shadow remains. But if it is set lower than 1, we still can see it, there is just less of a cube there. We can also go negative and it disappears again at minus 1. But at higher values, it is more prominent than previously. To receive the desired effect, you need to change these three settings a bit. Most importantly, SSS amount should be quite low. Now scene feels very foggy and dusty, but there are no signs of sun rays. This is because to create them we need to not only set up the diffuse object but also change some light settings accordingly. So I select the spotlight and proceed to the lights tab. Here we are interested in the spread angle setting. Right now the angle is very wide and the lighting is very scattered, so to make it more direct, I lower the spread angle. Right away the changes are obvious, but it is still not enough, we need to make it even more directed. Now it is more like it, looks like a god ray in all its glory. But I would say that the scene is way too foggy and dusty, so I lower the SSS amount even more. This looks much better. Also, you can lower the spread angle more, to make it thinner. This is the basics of creating a sunbeam. After this, you just take these basics and experiment with them. For example, I can bring back the HDRI at a lower setting, so it would light the surroundings a bit. And mess with the diffuse object settings to make the beam more visible and bright, without adding more dust and fog to the scene. It is now very bright. Also, I can use color grading settings from the tone mapping menu to change the scene and maybe make it better. For example, I can decrease the f/stop setting to overexpose the image a bit and make the beam brighter. And use other settings here, to make highlights brighter and lower saturation. Compensate all this by lowering environment intensity. In the end, I have a very visible and prominent sunbeam. Again, too dusty to my taste, it was a mistake to increase SSS amount. This is much better, I like it more. Like this, you can make the scene look and feel better. I urge you to experiment a bunch more with this because there are no ideal settings and parameters here, you will need to get a hang of this and decide on your own what to do. Some things can make your life easier in this regard though. I'm talking about specific products that can be found on the Daz3D.com shop. The first example is simple god rays. It adds a set of 4 transmapped props. So all you need to do is load the spotlight and a ray object and a god ray is ready. The iRay Ghost Light Kit 3 has a lot more than just adding god rays. But it is one of the functions, as we can see on these screenshots, especially on this one. Last but not least, epic props, God rays and volumetric light for iRay. If your single goal is to create God rays, this is a perfect product for you. This kit adds props that you can easily set up and add to the scene. God rays are done. On our website, renderguide.com, you can get a lot more information regarding 3D design using Daz Studio and Blender. And articles about useful 3D models and products for you. There is also a Daz3D God Rays lighting tutorial here with some additional content on this topic. For example, that you can use objects and scenery to create more interesting sun rays.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more inspiration.